It's been several days since the news broke that suggested Jody Wilson-Raybould, Canada's former Attorney General, may in fact have been demoted from her position because of a refusal to comply with pressure from the Prime Minister's office to intervene in the prosecution of SNC-Lavalin, Montreal-based engineering firm that has quite a sordid track record when it comes to corruption probes and bribery scandals. Since this story broke, no one in the government has deviated from Justin Trudeau's favorite talking points, that neither he nor anyone in his office directed Jody Wilson-Raybould to take any action in the SNC-Lavalin case. The Trudeau government has, through Trudeau himself, through spokespeople to the Prime Minister, through the new Attorney General, not deviated from that line, that Prime Minister's office staff did not direct Jody Wilson-Raybould. The obvious questions when someone only uses one phrasing of a sentence is, what are they trying to hide? Did they pressure in some other way? Did someone from a different department pressure Jody Wilson-Raybould? These are questions to which we don't know the answer, and currently there's no willingness from the government to provide transparency in this issue at all. The former Attorney General, Jody Wilson-Raybould, is claiming solicitor-client privilege prevents her from divulging what happened in the course of her representing Canada as its Attorney General. But there's a problem with that. You see, the government of Canada exists for one reason only, and that is to serve the people of Canada. Which means that the government of Canada's lawyer, the Attorney General, is ultimately there to represent the people. You can't represent the government without representing the people that government represents. Which means the Attorney General needs to be accountable to the people. This is not just her representing some corporation in ongoing litigation. It's her serving as the country's lawyer, which certainly should require some accountability to the country itself. And what's worse than this is that we have Trudeau showing himself to be a hypocrite once again. In 2013 and 2014, when he was just the third party leader, he would often talk about how the Harper government at the time was not being transparent. And he said that he was going to be the new age of transparency. He was going to bring that in. Most notably, he promised that government information should be open by default, transparency by default. He used those words, as in everything should be for the public to know unless there's a reason otherwise, as opposed to picking and choosing what the government should be transparent about. It's amazing how soon he forgot that promise. Here we have a case where the government could very easily waive that solicitor-client privilege to allow there to be transparency. The government could comply with the calls from the opposition for an open investigation and probe into this, but instead, they're relying on one single line, one single sentence that the Prime Minister denies that anyone was directed to behave in a certain way. And if the media lets up on this, that one line may be enough. But there's a lot more to the story here, and no one in the government is prepared to talk about it. For True North, I'm Andrew Lawton.